First John. And the title, What Love Got to Do with It? Amen. What do love have to do with it? When I read this and I thought about it and I went back and I thought about Moses when he was bringing the children out of Egypt. Amen. And when you think about it, all the things that they went through, and I can hear God talking to Moses and telling him, I'm your protector. I'm going to be with you. Amen? From that time on, as they went through the wilderness and everything, Moses must have had a lot of love for these people. In other words, he had a lot of love for God. Amen? Because he may have questioned God about what he had to do, what his task was, but God gave him the answer. Just do what I say. Follow my instruction. Amen? So, therefore, Moses must really love God. But what the Bible said that all that they went through, it could not have been nothing but love. Amen? Now today, in this different generation, every time you turn on TV, there's all types of crime, people taking the other lives, different type of conspiracy. And when you look at it and you think about it, what kind of love is that? That another man would take another man's life? I can understand in a war type situation, but you're not in war, you're not in the service, but you're taking someone else's life and you don't even know who they are. How can you say you love somebody? How can you say you have love? How can you say you love yourself? I can't see me loving myself and I'm doing somebody else wrong. Come on, somebody. What love has to do with it? Well, let's take a look at it. God says in his word, behold, let us love one another. That's God's word, not man's word, God's word. And when you really think about it, you can look at it from different angles. God said love everybody. How can you love God and you're talking back to your mother? How can you love God and you want to jump on your father? Come on, somebody. How can you love God and hurt other people? That's because you don't love yourself. A lot of us go through things. And each one of us sin each day because of love. Somehow, some way of some type form, we can't say we love everybody. Because, well, the simple fact is, a lot of us don't even know a lot of people. and we first take a look at these people and we make our own judgment in our mind and don't even know their name. I have been guilty of that, so have a lot of other people. You know, back sometime, you know, you can be in a building or somewhere, a gathering, and if someone comes in talking loud and everybody takes a look at that person, and already, you already done picked out your judgment, what type of person this person is, amen? This mob, he ain't got but a lot of mouth, all he's doing is talking. He talks too much. You see, how can you say you love somebody and you don't even know their name? You've never been properly introduced. How can you love your mother and you curse her out? How can you love your father and you curse him out? You see, there's a lot of parts in this situation in John here. You got to look at the whole scenario, the whole picture. It basically is love. The key to life is love. And you wonder sometimes, well, I guess we all do it, I do it. You can have a disagreement with someone in your home or your family, or you could have one of the spouses, or you could be helping somebody that don't have a place to stay, and you do all that you can, and then when they get a little income or something, they neglect to take care of the responsibility. And we as human beings, we have something to say, and it's not loving, amen? For some reason or another, life takes its course. In other words, what I'm trying to tell you, the flesh and the negative attitude comes in our heart and our mind. And we make statements towards people. We make statements to them. We express our feelings to them, and it's not a loving feeling. Amen? It's not what God wanted us to do. Now, God seen and realized that this world was in a bad shape. When Moses brought the children out of Egypt, they was in a bad shape. There was no love, really. And still today, there's not much love. If you're not abiding in this word, love, that is the number one thing in order to being saved. Even though you have accepted God as your Lord and Savior, you must have love in order to say you are a real Christian. Amen? In order to say that you're a man of God, you must have love in your heart for your fellow man. Regardless of they put their hands on you, regardless if they curse you, you still supposed to have love. Now, sometimes we ask ourselves, how can I have love for a man that's putting his hands on me? How can I have love for this woman that's putting her hands on me? How can I have love for this woman that's calling the law on me? You see, how can I have love for anybody that disrespects me? But Jesus said, if a man put his hands on you, turn the other cheek. God said, man come to you and he's hungry, give him something to eat. If a man needs a shirt, give him the shirt off your back. That's a whole lot of love. But I still understand we all don't stand up to those expectations. All of us not going to feed someone that we don't know. All of us not going to welcome somebody in our home that we do not know. But the Lord is telling you, step out on faith and love your brothers and sisters. As we know, there are a lot of ministers back in the day, and even in this time, that have traveled the highways and the byways and have picked up strangers and gave them a ride. Amen? There have been situations where preachers have picked up strangers and lost their lives. Come on, somebody. But it's now in the time of the year, and this time, 2018, it's hard for somebody to take you in. It's hard for somebody to get a ride because there's so much hatred. There's so much crime. There are so many people taking other people's lives for a little of nothing. I remember back when I used to hitchhike. It wasn't hard to get a ride. Back in the day, we didn't lock the front door. You sleep on the front porch and leave your house wide open. You see, but now it's a different generation and it's not safe. Every time we look around, there's a home invasion. Every time we look around, you can't even go to the gas station without somebody trying to take your car or even pull up to the stoplight. You see, this is not how this world has posed to be. This generation here supposed been a lot different than it was back in the day, and which it is. They didn't have light, we have light. They didn't have running water, we got running water. As time goes on, the word of God still stands. You must love your brother and sister as well as you love yourself. If I don't take care of myself right, how can I take care of all? If I don't take care of little Miss Bird, and I don't take care of it. How can you have love for one another? God's son came and died on the cross for what? One reason. Because he loved us. And his father knew that in order to save his people, he had to send his son down here in order to make a sacrifice. Come on, somebody. So that's a lot of love, ain't it, bro? This man died on the cross for us that we may have everlasting life. And we confess with our mouth that he is Lord. And we still have hatred in our heart for somebody else. But this morning, I want you to know that remember and ask God to help us to love somebody. This morning, Lord, we ask you to help us to love our loved ones. Help us to love our family. As well as, Lord God, as we say we love ourselves. Sometimes we don't even love ourselves, Lord. That we are hurt somebody, that's because we are angry with ourselves, with what's in us. Lord, I come to you this morning asking you that put more love in my heart. Put more understanding. Because there are times in our life, my life, your life, that when we're not so much understanding and there's really not so much love in our heart because sometimes we express ourselves in the wrong way. I'm guilty of that. Sometimes different thoughts come in our mind. children may get on your nerve, family members may get on your nerve, and after a while, you don't show that love that you have for them. And you got those small kids nowadays, when you discipline them, or you raise your voice at them, or you pop them on the hand, and they're crying, they say, and they will ask you this question, I thought you loved me. You see, this generation of children now will ask you some questions that you would not believe. So therefore, you must raise your children right because they are looking at you. They are looking at you, and how you act and how you carry yourself is depending on what they do. Amen. If you bring your child and children up right, and you respect yourself and do what you're supposed to do as a mother and father, those kids will come out right. They will love you, and they will respect you. Let us stand. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, we ask that you help us to love one another. Mm-hmm.